Ayan, hello, hello. So this is a personal request from one of our students regarding the company, no, the stock called Dito, D-I-T-O. No? So sa ngayon, the total value being traded, one of the most active, no, 39 million shares. It was last traded at 3.68. It's up 1.94% today. So this is the total market capitalization is about 10.2 billion pesos. There are now about 1,125 trades. So puro call financial yung nagba-buy and sell. Dito CME. Ngayon the bid size is 162,000 and 15 is lots yun, no? 367 yung price ng buying. Although the selling, yung pinaka lowest ngayon is 3.68. Since mas marami itong buying, malamang matupad itong 3.67 na to. And then eventually 3.66, maybe it will go down that big. Pero meron tayong selling na 1 million shares, no? At 3.67, at 3.69. So let's see who will give way. So sa ngayon, let's look at the valuation. At dito tayo magsimula muna tayo sa valuation and then eventually saka na tayo magpunta sa profile muna pala. So dito CME, incorporation date January 1925, AB Stock Transfers Corporation. Annual meeting nila is first Friday of May at 4 p.m. ISM Corporation nga pala ito, no? Okay, so tingnan natin yung kanyang valuation. This is from 2015, no? Yung kanilang price from 140 naging 131, 140 kasi ito yung ISM, no? Before, and then naging 603, parang bumibili pa ako nito before, ha? 2018, 344 no 2019. Ang medyo concern, at ito, nung una nakita ko to, parang sabi ko, kailangan pa ba natin itong i-analyze? Pero let's see, kasi sa ngayon, no, ang kanyang concern is that losing earnings niya, including non-recurring items, is negative 459 million, negative 17, negative 34. So, puro negative siya, past 5 years. Book value niya nag-move from 2.61 before book value per share, ngayon 1.48 na lang ang book value. Matataas, ha? Price to earnings, syempre walang earnings. Price to sales, wala, not applicable. Price to book value 2.33, price to cash 2098 no 2019. Price to cash flow negative. Talagang in the end pupunta na naman tayo rito sa ano lang, eh, sa chart. Let's look at the chart. So, tingnan natin yung chart plus RSI. Ayan. Sige, chart muna. Chart muna. So, sa chart lang, so you will notice, andito tayo ngayon with the Bollinger Bands and moving averages. Simple moving averages lang. So, yung blue line is the 75-day moving average, while the green is the 200-day. So, a long-term natin 200, ang medium ay 75. So, ang medium ay pataas, ang long term ay nasa baba niya. So, medyo uptrend siya. Right? Hindi ko alam kung makikita natin yung ADX. Yes, it's an uptrend. Maganda yung trend. Okay, so, mukhang tama naman yung idea natin. So, it's an uptrend. Ngayon, pag uptrend, tingnan natin yung Bollinger, no? So, ang Bollinger natin, nagkaroon ng breakout somewhere here in May of 2020. The breakout was upwards and then eventually dito nagkaroon ng weakness nung bandang June 23, went down and then ito na naman tayo pataas. Dito tayo, no? So since ang Bollinger natin ay uptrend ang Bollinger, so here makita natin na nag decrease yung kanyang yung size ng Bollinger, yung bands, no? Nag-narrow dito and then umangat na naman. Ngayon is parang healthy naman yung ano niya. Hindi naman siya nasa breakout ulit, no? Although nagkaroon siya ng narrowing stage pero napakaikli lang, so hindi mo masasabi na breakout ulit ito, no? But let's look at the RSI. Ngayon kasi yung Bollinger nagkakaroon ng movement beyond ng Bollinger. So katulad nito, nagkaroon ng umangat siya beyond the Bollinger bands. And then the next is a red candle. So ito is we are saying that it's now moving towards a sell position. Although wala naman tayong sell short dito, hindi natin masabi pa na yun yung indicator because yung RSI niya hindi pa rin overbought. But let's look at this from the perspective kasi ng value. Ang dito, kaya ito nagiging popular is because of the speculation on, alam na naman yun, no, kung bakit, no? And the holding corporation supposed to where it will be coming from, no? The telco. Ngayon, with no income yet, so everything is speculation. The chart will always go like this, up and down, up and down, up and down, until we have the confirmation that it's really coming into fruition. And then eventually, it's now earning. Ako kasi, from my perspective, I don't really want to gamble my money on that. More of yung talagang sure rewards and benefits, doon ako nakatingin. Kasi nga, pera yan eh, totoong pera yan eh. Mabuti kung pinaglalaroan mo, mga play money lang or mga virtual money lang, no? Totoong pera to eh. So, I don't really participate in this kind of speculation trading. Lalo pat wala pa talaga siya napapatunayan na income. Although some people would do so. Kasi nga, hindi man siya real income, but there's this speculation of what will happen if they are indeed listed at nandito dito mag-list ng third telco. Okay? So yun po, yun yung nagiging concern ko rito sa ano to. Frankly, ako, I will not buy this, no? And on the trading perspective naman, it has already gone so high up. So you have missed already the opportunity. The opportunity happened here somewhere dito. Of course, kung titingnan natin yung mas matagal pa, let's look at 1 year. Kung saan talagang lumampas siya sa Bollinger on the buy side, which is itong part na to, no? And then the next day is a green candle. March 13 would be a perfect buy position. Especially since malapit siya sa oversold levels. Yan, itong part na to. So March 13 would have been great. And it closed only at about 1 peso. You could have already quadrupled your money in the next 6 months had you seen this or had you participated in this position. Kaso, wala na eh. By now, it's too late and it's 2020 on the hindsight, but now it's too late. So, ano ngayon moving forward? Again, I would not recommend to buy it. Wala naman short selling. Kasi lahat ito speculation trading. If you're into speculation, if you're into trading, then okay lang naman. Pero sa ngayon, hindi rin naman siya magandang entry point, no? Kasi pababa siya. So wait some more. Let's see the indicators kung saan siya pupunta. But we know where the emotions, you know, are coming from. And we know that it's going to be played by a lot of individuals and even mga institutional investors. Kaya huwag kayong masyadong sasabay sa kanila dahil eventually, pag nagbagsakan yan, hindi ka kagad makaka-exit dahil no one wants to buy anyway. Kaya importante talaga na just stay in the sidelines until you are perfectly sure na talagang you wanna go all in. Ako kasi ganun ang idea ko eh. If I cannot go all in on a company, then I won't buy that company. Kasi ang all in, ang idea kasi ng all in is that you are betting everything eh. The farm and all the rest that are in the farm. you're betting the farm, and Becky, the cow. Diba? And if you cannot go all that, all in, at that rate, then ako, I don't participate. If I'm not so sure. So sa ngayon dito, not even in trading, is it a buy? So might as well just pass. Pass. Pass tayo dyan. So that's it for dito. Thank you very much.